Watch your credit cards. Cue the fire. The banks. The banksters. They're going to come for you. You want to know why? Because they're not making the money like they were making. And they are bracing for tragedy. And actually, I'm curious. Hey, babe, can you come in here? Sorry, she has to come in. Can you let me know what you think of this right here? What? Can you see it? She doesn't want to be on camera. What do you think? Gotta read it. But it's okay. It can't be that bad. At least I don't have approval ratings at 33%. Oh my gosh. Wait till he finds out he's president. I mean, this kid cannot catch a break. Standing there, giving a speech prepared. Birds pooping all over. Not very good aim, though. They're close. They're getting there. It's like North Korea with their little drone bird poop. They're like, we missed it. And hopefully you guys are not invested in bank stocks. Oh my gosh, all of them. All of them under the 200. Not looking good. Bank earnings. Oh, and Twitter. Did you see what? Sorry. ADHD. Elon trying to buy all of Twitter. Homie gets rejected. Bank earnings signal dark clouds on the horizon for you. And now these guys, these cats, the Fed, the private, it looks so government, doesn't it? They make it all government. It's just private bank. They fake the people out. They do it. They keep repeating this. Wall Street's biggest players had a rough start to the year. I'll show you how it's going to affect you. All of the biggest U.S. banks saw profits take a hit in the first 3 months of 2022, ending the boom. Citi, Goldman Sachs, Morgan, and Wells Fargo. And if you want to know how much they lost, somewhere between 42 and 46%. No! So with the banks losing so much money, and we are all shedding a tear right now. Guys, they're going to come after you. And you're not taking out loans either. What are they going to do? Well, let's crash the market. Because if you watched my video from yesterday, how do banks make money? Is it by you depositing money? No. That's a liability to them. And you're welcome. A lot of you guys are like, oh my gosh, do more of that. I'm like, I would. But people get really glazed over and the watch time is very small. And I do know what it's like being small. It does not have benefit. But look at what is going on. We're moving into I would not want to be a president. Woo. So welcome to recession. Welcome to no lending. Welcome to nothing. Welcome to all the asset values that went up are going to go down. Oh, and some of you guys are like, well, what do we do? Where would you say? Listen to Warren, okay? When there is blood in the streets, you're going to want to have what? That would be cash. See, when you have those assets, when you have cash in the bankster's little accounts, you can go buy real estate. You can go buy all these things that people are like, I don't know, I'm filing for bankruptcy. Here, take it. Actually, funny story. One of the properties I picked up on the water, right, during the, we're all going to die. The guy had a bankruptcy because he owned restaurants. And the land was like, you take it. I'm like, I'll take it. Because remember, kids, the important thing about real estate is location, location, location. Always buy water. But here we go. JP Morgan. Love those guys. Profits drop 42%. Bank write downs. What? Russia? See, the things that happen over there affect us over here. JP Morgan Chase said its first quarter profits dropped by 42% from last year, partly because the bank had to write down nearly $1.5 billion in assets. Well, because they did see this coming. And actually, if you understood charts, Jamie, you would have seen this a long time ago. See, we could come over here and look at banking stocks. Oh, I can go do this here, Citi. Let's take a look. What are some important things? Let's do this together as a family. And I'll turn on a couple lines for you just so you can understand. You could be ahead of Jamie Dimon and everyone else. Okay, see that blue line? That's the 200-day moving average. The minute you cross under that, and I'm just guessing, I bet you there is a golden cross somewhere in this zone that will tell you the stock is heading lower. And then you see you have a trend line. This would be support and resistance, currently turned into resistance. And you don't want resistance heading down. But look, when I turn on the death cross, look at that. How cute. Did I get it? Did I get that right? Was I about? I don't know. Rewind the tape, Jimmy. So underneath the 200, very critical, important level. Everyone knows. And if you are talking stocks, I stay away. Anything underneath that 200-day, stocks. Bonds different, gold's different, commodities, those are, you want to buy them really cheap because it's not like oil is going to go away. So when oil went to free,
maybe that's a good time to buy it.
But let's move along down the list. We have Bank of America, death cross as of today. But no, Johnny Bravo, let me turn on some other lines just because it cleans it up and people are like, oh, okay. Look, it's a double bottom. Yeah, you it's a double bottom. You just have one big problem. You're under the 200-day moving average. And I know there's a channel, I don't know which one it is. Someone was like, bank stocks, buy, you know, at the beginning of the year, like more. I wouldn't, not my kind of swing trade. Goldman Sachs, look, they hit underneath. They had a death cross way back there. We're still moving on down. What do we got? Wells Fargo? Oh, it's approaching. Oh, we have resistance. I lied. We have support, but the problem is you're under the 200-day moving average. Heading down lower, what do we have? Morgan Stanley, another, a death cross falling. And some of you guys are like, oh, Bravo, everything's going down. What are you talking about? Really? I have a watch list every single day. I put out stocks for you above the 200-day moving average. RYI. We have been killing it on the swing trade. Here, I'll teach you how to swing trade in under 2 seconds. See this? See the red line? Yeah, it closed above, okay? That beat down, it was hanging on that red line. You still had a green one. Probably you may want to have held your position above the 200. Okay, you're up 78% on your money. Your, what is this called? Paper trading. I was like, what do we do here? We only paper trade on this channel. What was our next run? I put it in the course. Your next run was, let me grab out my handy dandy ruler. We are up 19%. You're welcome. There's only three things that I want you to be aware of on this one. So don't go run out there and buy it. You're overbought. Everyone's like, oh my gosh, I wish I was Johnny Bravo. Another, you had a cross on the MACD. Third, you are going to have to exit on April, when are you going to exit? Exit May 3rd. Just remember, May the 4th be with you. That's when you're going to want to exit that one. Also, if you're like, oh my gosh, how do you know these things? Link in the description. I teach you how to swing trade. Take that course. Learn how to swing trade. Don't take my advance. Just whatever coupon code, grab it. You can do this and you can wait for blood in the streets. And when there is blood in the streets, everyone's going to be pointing fingers, just like Jamie. Jamie Dimon says powerful forces threaten U.S. economy. Bank's first quarter profit fell by 40%. Yeah, defaults. We got Russia. We got China. We got who's going to invade who next. And I say I don't want to be on the wrong side of this trade. I am going to trade it all day long so I can go play on a boat or I can go surf. And everyone can point fingers. I don't care. Because psychopaths be psychopaths, and they all go to war, and the people always get hurt. And when there's sanctions, who gets hurt? The people get hurt. Or when there's wars, which I served in one. Yep, Desert Shield, Desert Storm. Who gets hurt? So I figured real quickly, F y'all, I'm going to take you guys. We're all going to find an island. We're going to live our lives. Not going to argue. If you have a kid named Skyler, we're kicking him off the island. Kid's a total nightmare. Get them out of my class. That way, if you do things like start businesses, trade equities, copy the rich, blame politicians, your life will be so much. Look, ooh, Tesla beat. Boy, Elon, did I already talk? I already did. Facebook, Zuckbucks down, Tesla down, S&P down, NASDAQ down. The Dow just hanging in there. All few dozens of those companies. Retirees with credit card debt face debilitating financial consequences. And cue the fire. That is not good for this guy. Maybe you should cut back on coffee or, you know, I don't know, tighten the belt. The shares of U.S. credit card debt owed by people over 70 years old has been growing in recent years. And you know why that is? Let me turn the fire off. And I think I just made more fire. Fire off. Thank you, Google. But guys, if you understand how this monetary system works, it's like musical chairs, okay? And if you think you're going to retire, you're probably not, because you're just it doesn't work that way. The dollar and the way money is created, it's debt. Debt has to be paid back with interest. Oh, problem. And every day they remove a chair out of the musical chairs. And someone's like, oh, where do I sit? Well, you can go sit being homeless. So your whole life, and I am sorry that the system has been created this way. Your whole life is you're going to have to work and you're going to have to start businesses, trade equities, and make more money every year. If you do not do that, you will drown. You will drown in debt. You will drown without money, right? You're like, man, why? Because the costs of everything will always go up. The value of the dollar will always go down. So even just recently, with the value of the dollar going down, purchasing power going down, inflation going up 20% in a year, whatever it is, right? That means you had to make 20% more. Well, where are you? I'm not making 20% more. So what do? You put it on the credit card. And if you are older like me and you have a fixed income, well, that's not going to work out. And some of you guys are like, well, if you just buy a house and pay it off, really? How's that working out for you? You have a thing called property tax. That goes up every single second. You actually don't even get to own it. I know, the American dream, having your own house with the white picket fence and having it paid off, but yet, I gotta pay $4,000 a month on property tax. And then the next year, it's $5,000 a month. And then the next year, it's $6,000 a month. And then the cost of living goes up and gas goes up, right? You see? Like, you always have to work. I'm sorry. And I know there is a statistic, I do not know if it is right, but they say a male, the average male, after when he retires, usually life expectancy, 2 years. Probably after 2 years, he's like, I can't make it. And so then people go back to work. That's what they do. They retire. They're like, oh, shoot, I'm drowning here. Go back to work. And I'll tell you, people were living high on the hog, right? With government intervention. Oh, see that gray bar? That gray bar is a recession. And the government was like, everyone gets money. And what did you do? This is your savings account. You all had lots of money in your savings account. Now, because of how the system is, you have no money in your savings account. And it's pretty simple. After you have no money in your savings account, now you put it on the credit card. And now they raise the rates. That's great. So all the money that you put on a credit card, rates go up, you have to pay more every month, then you file for bankruptcy, we have a recession, and then we go back to them giving you lots of money again. So, and here's one for you, might confuse you. This is cash assets of all commercial banks going through the roof. Well, look, we rolled. Also, if you understand how to chart, which I found in life, charts can be used on all things. Looking at this, left shoulder, head, right shoulder, neckline, we are going to go from here. All of those assets are going to go down right here and find some. Isn't that crazy? And in yesterday's video, I said this, the assets, cash in the bank is moving. And guess where it's going to move to? All the way down here until then. See, again, different sides of the market on how to play it. Then when we get down into this my hair zone or my ear zone right here, right? Then the government comes in. The Fed's like, oops. We screwed the pooch, our bad. Guess we're gonna have to make a whole lot more money, but be ready. You guys gotta be ready. There's gonna be blood in the streets. You're gonna wanna have cash assets to buy up all the fun stuff. And what I mean by buying fun stuff, sure, buy your 57 Chevy Bile. Don't do it right now. Mother, front door, 82%. Almost all, everyone paid above sticker price for new vehicles in January. If you move this to 1 year, you're not going to see this. You're not going to see everyone paying above sticker. No, car salesmen are like, man, this is not good. I haven't sold a car in a month. And what happens when you haven't sold a car in a month? Yep, you start putting sale. Although I will have to say that people that own these lots with vehicles, they figured out this whole supply and demand thing, right? If you can keep the supply off, it raises demand and it raises prices. And they really don't want to go back to having to, like, well, we have every color that you want. We have every... Nope, they would prefer just to keep it, well, we have one. But there's three people standing in line that want that one. So yes, definitely, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, tighten the belt buckle on the whole car purchase right now. Walk. I don't have a car. Actually, my wife has a car. It is an electric car, and she gets... The car is paid off, it's an electric car, and she gets free gas because she just plugs in. The apartment, yes, apartment that we are living at pays for it. So I think insurance is $100 and something a month. Oh, and I have an, okay, I'll tell you the modes of transportation. One, shoes. Two, I have an electric scooter, like a skateboard. I know. This guy. Will you ever grow up? I also have an electric bike. And if you want to know what bike I have, this is what I have. Here you go. Here's my car, a Pivot Shuttle. This is me. Oh, and if you want to know my skateboard, that is my skateboard, right? They're like, oh, this guy, can you get out of the road, man? What are you doing here? See, I like it. It reminds me of surfing just on concrete. Oh, and coming in from I told you so over the last 6 months, you just have to wait for these things. Man, you always look like an idiot when you're like, we're going to have a recession. They're like, no, this is the strongest market we've ever had. Okay. U.S. retail sales growth slowest in 13 months as online spending plunged. Didn't see that one coming. Also, for those of you, I know I brought it up, that ADHD, Elon Musk offers to buy Twitter for $43 billion. Every share, what, $50, $55? I don't know. I'm not looking at the stock right now. So it can be transformed as a private company. I would say he got rejected. You can't just be like, I want to buy your whole company. Okay, shareholders. Everyone that owns shares of the... Oh, hello there, Jack Dorsey. Sorry about that. Can I just buy it all? So be very careful when it comes to charting Twitter, because this is definitely news. When, like, hey, I'm going to buy your whole company. Woo! Oh, I'm not going to buy... Woo! So just be aware. I actually would like... That'd be nice, right? You know, you got... We need social media where you all just can talk and we're not censored. Hi, YouTube. Oh, my God. Oh, wait. We have live? What? Live? Is it Biden? President Biden? Delivers? Oh, that should be a good one. Let's end the video now and head on over to our president. And I will see you in the next video.